Let's work the following problems. Let's recall that the square root of negative 1 is equal to I. All right, so if we look at our first problem, find the square root of negative 81. We're going to write it as a complex number. Let's remember this is the same thing as the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 81. We know the square root of 81, that is 9, and we now know we can write the square root of negative 1 as I. So this is 9i. Let's do the same thing in the second problem. We can rewrite this as the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 144. And our second radical, we can rewrite as the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 25. We know the square root of 144, it's 12. And the square root of negative 1, we can now write as I. We know the square root of 25, that's 5. And again, let's write the square root of negative 1 as I. And these we can consider like terms since they both contain I. So let's just add 12 and 5 gives us 17i. All right, let's do the same thing to each of these. The square root of negative 25 can be written as negative 1 times the square root of 25. And of course, we know that we can write square root of negative 1 as I. Square root of 25 is 5, and the square root of 25 is 5. So this gives us 25i. All right, well, let's look at this next one. We already know from the example we just did that the square root of negative 25 is really just 5i. And, of course, the second one is also 5i. So if we multiply these together, 5 times 5 is 25, and I times I is I squared. Now, here's where, from the notes, we need to remember that I squared is the same thing as negative 1. So if we replace I squared with negative 1, this is actually equal to negative 25. All right, now, let's keep in mind for this next question that I squared is the same thing as negative 1. So I'm going to replace this I squared with a negative 1. Here, I to the fifth is the same thing as I times I squared times I squared. If I add up the exponents, I to the first, I squared, and I squared, that's I to the fifth. So each of those I squareds I can replace with a negative 1. So now I'm going to have the following. And now if I multiply out all the numbers, I'll have 6 times negative 1 is negative 6, times 3 is negative 18, times negative 1 is positive 18, and times negative 1 again is negative 18, and a single